So good evening everyone. So this video we are going to discuss about compensators. So mainly in the series and feedback compensation we are going to discuss in this video. So usually the compensator which can be used to increase the system stability as well as accuracy and faster response to the system for that. So whenever the controller it have slow down, so those time they are going to add over the compensator to increasing the stability, accuracy, faster response to the system, they can add the compensator. Here a control system is usually required to meet the three times response specifications, namely steady state accuracy, damping factor and settling time to get decide a design with minimum errors and to adjust the parameter of the overall system to satisfy the design criterion to an additional subsystem called compensator must be used over there. Okay, so here given the control plan, the procedure of control design is satisfy requirement is called compensation. So normally here while increasing the efficiency of the compensator, we are going to add the pole as well as zeros. Okay, the pole if you add, accuracy will be more. Zeros if you are going to add, stability of the system it increases over there. So why we require the compensator? Okay, so the closed loop system has the function of self tuning by selecting particular value of the gain k. Some single performance requirement may be met, compensator is okay. And is it possible to meet more than one performance of requirement? Sometimes it's not possible. Okay, something new to be done to the system in order to make the perform required. Now we will discuss about the series compensation. So here R of S is the input, C of S is the output. So the transfer function we are going to place our controller. So a feedback system it will be goes over here. So now between the error detector and controller, the compensator they are going to place over here. Okay, from the error signal whatever things it comes, suddenly it will be detect and send the signal to the controller and it work proper and faster rate. Okay, so this is also called as cascade compensation and series compensation. So this type of compensator is a physical device. The transfer function is denoted as a G of S. Okay, so here the compensator is placed between the error detector and the plant in the forward path. Okay, and here the flow of signal in such series scheme is from lower energy level towards higher energy level. They require additional amplifiers to increase the gain and also to provide the necessary isolation. The number of components required in the series scheme is more than in parallel compensation. Then comes into the next thing, feedback compensation. So the feedback compensation compensator is connected in the parallel manner, so that also it is called as parallel compensation. See, the controller, compensator, feedback path. Okay, here also in between the error detector and controller, the compensator signal it will be goes over here. So here the energy transfer in such a parallel scheme from higher energy level towards lower energy level level of point, hence the such a scheme additional amplifier are not required, thus the number of components required are less than required in this series scheme. Okay, so this is about the feedback compensation. Next we are going to discuss about the series feedback compensator. So in the series feedback compensator, R of S input, so here one compensator is connected, another component compensator is connected parallel to the controller. Okay, the feedback signal is provided over here. Okay, so this is about the construction of the series and feedback compensation. So in this one, it's necessary to provide the type of compensation, series as well as feedback. Such a scheme is called series parallel compensation. The arrangement there in this figure. So the selection of proper compensation scheme depends on the nature of the signals available in the system. The power level at various points, available components, the economic consideration and designer experience. Okay, so this is about the series parallel compensation. So mainly this compensator which can be employed for to increase the efficiency of the system. Okay, so mainly the efficiency in the sense it will be faster response to particular system and increase the accuracy and stability. How we are going to increase all those things? Suppose if you add the zeros, stability it will be increases and a faster rate it will be worse. Suppose if you add the poles, accuracy it will be increased over here. So like this way, adding the zeros and poles factor, so it will be increases the efficiency of the systems. So mainly poles, accuracy, zeros, stability as well as faster response. So for that, those things it will be added over here. So with that, we are going to stop over this this video. The remaining thing we will see in the next video. Thank you.